Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 7, weather, climate and adaptation. So children, yesterday we have done adaptation. What kind of adaptation animals have, those who are living in tropical rainforest. Since a huge area of different part of a country is covered with a tropical rainforest. In India also we will find it out. Tropical rainforest near Western Ghats also, and in Assam also. So that tropical rainforest, which are such a kind of a hot and humid weather they have. So how the animals, those who are living in that tropical rainforest, how they adapt themselves, how they use their part of their body in modified, in such a modified way that they can protect us, and they protect them also, and they can live in that tropical rainforest easily. So here today I am going to do adaptation. What kind of a adaptation is required for the animals, those who are living in desert area. Again, desert is a very important area. If we are talking about the land area covered by the different geographical location, if I am going to talk about different geographical position or location, then desert is one of the area. Like Sahara Desert is the largest desert. Then we have Thar Desert also. In India also, most of the Rajasthan is covered with desert only. So desert, and in Gujarat also Thar Desert is there. So what kind of a climatic condition over there in desert, that we are going to see. Then geographical location, that we will see. And after that we'll come to the next, that is your adaptation in desert animal. What kind of adaptation we required in the desert animal. Now if I'm going to talk about desert animal, one animal that will click in your mind, that is camel. Now how camel can easily walk in the desert? How camel can survive without water for 1 week? So there is certain adaptation in that camel, so that they can survive in that particular kind of an environment. So that only we are going to see today. Now adaptation in animals living in desert area. First of all, the geographical position is that hot desert are located in tropical region, that is near equator. In our country also, in India also, if you will find it out, that desert is there near equator only. Equator, which is passes through Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. So in Gujarat we have Thar Desert, which is located near equator only. Now what kind of a climatic condition? So we will be doing adaptation in animals living in desert area. Adaptation in animals living in desert. Now this is very important. Some of the certain common adaptation which is there in all the animals. Now certain adaptation which is there in only some animals. So now adaptation in animals living in desert area. First of all, geographical location, that all the desert is present near equator. Now in India also Gujarat, the Thar Desert is present near equator only. Number two, what kind of a climatic condition? Climatic condition is dry and hot condition of desert. But at night that will become cold. Why is it so? That desert area, the sand which is present in deserts, that will get heat up in the daytime due to the heat of sun, but at the night it will cool down since sun is not shining at night. So it will cool down quickly. So at night in desert we find it out that in the daytime the weather is so hot, and at the night it suddenly it will drop down that temperature. So that is there. Now days are very hot, night are very cold, and there is excessive shortage of water. Nowadays, if you will went to Rajasthan or Gujarat or that Thar desert area, now they have now artificial sources of water was created in that area, like that is lake was created, then certain canals were also created, through which their water supply or excessive shortage was getting removed. Now, adaptation in hot desert, what kind of adaptation is required? Like, first thing, that animals, those who live in hot desert, they are like camels and kangaroos. Camels have long leg which help them to away from the heat of the desert. Then they have padded feet which help them to walk easily on in the desert, that their feet does not move inside that soil. Then to avoid heat, they conserve water inside their body. They can drink approximately 20 to 30 liters of water at once go, and then they store that water inside their body, which will be later used for the when they required it. Now, the skin of the desert animal is without sweat gland. Now, in our body, we have sweat gland. So, but the animals, those who live in that area, they do not have sweat gland. So, first of all, the different animals, those who live in this area, that is camels. Then we have kangaroos, then we have rat, then rabbits also, many rattles also. These are me, rabbits and rat. Now, here the adaptation of camel is the finest. That is why camel is known as the ship of the desert. Now, what all adaptation? Now, the certain common adaptation which all these animals have, first, that they make their burrows inside the sand and they move inside when it is very hot outside in the daytime, and they came out from their burrows at the night. So that adaptation was taken up by rabbit. Then they can drink a lot of water at one go. That adaptation was taken by camel. Kangaroo, they can jump over that sand quickly. They can walk easily. They do not have sweat gland. The animals, those who are living in desert area, they do not have sweat gland. Now, these are the certain adaptation which is common. Now, desert adaptation in camel, what kind of... Now, these common adaptation you are not going to remember. Now, these adaptation you will remember only for all the animals. For all the animals, like this heading. What are the adaptation we found in desert animal? If the question is this, then you are going to write number one, that first is that to avoid heat, they live in burrows at the daytime. They live in burrows during day, and came out from burrows at night during daytime. That is the first. They do not have sweat gland. So that is one of the important adaptation which help them to reduce the water of content from their body. Number three is that they excrete concentrated urine. They excrete concentrated urine. They excrete concentrated urine. Fine. So these are the certain this 1, 2, 3 adaptation is common for all the desert animal. Now after this we are going to do some of the adaptation which is normally find it out in camels. Since camel is the most founded animal in the desert and camel is also known as ship of the desert. Why camel is only known as ship of the desert? That we are going to do it by doing the adaptation. Now adaptation in camel, we will see what are all adaptation that camel have. Adaptation in camel, that is an important topic. Adaptation in camels, those who are living in desert, obviously that camels are living in desert areas. Now first, they have large padded feet. Fine. Limbs of a camel have large pads. Now camel is the well adapted animal according to desert area, that they can easily survive in desert area. They can drink water at once go, they can drink a lot of water, and then they do not require water for next one week. So that is a such kind of an adaptation. That is why they are known as ship of the desert. Since that there is a scarcity of water in that that particular area in Rajasthan, and in that they can walk without water for 1 week, and once they will get water they can drink 15 to 20 liters of water easily, and they can store it inside their body. That is why camels are known as ship of the desert. So let's see that what all adaptation camels have to survive in this desert area. Now the first is that they have padded feet which help them to walk easily in the sand. It has a hump which is used to store fat. It has padded feet. Padded feet and padded feet which help them to walk easily, in sand. Number two, long legs keep them away, from the heat of the sun. Camel have long leg which keep them away from the heat of the sun. Fine. So these long legs will keep them away from the hot sand. That is why they can easily walk in that sand during the daytime. You have seen that these camels are only used in camel cart also in desert areas. People are also sitting on these camels and then moving through that desert area. So camel are widely used animals due to these such kind of an adaptation. Now number three adaptation, it has hump. It has hump at its back. Now what is the advantage of hump? Which is used to store fat in that hump. Like if sometime that camel have eaten their food or taken their food, and then they are going to store that food in their hump, and then that can be utilized later on. If they do not get food, the energy can be extracted from that hump only, the fat which is already stored. this same kind of a thing we will be also having. Like when we are fasting for some days, then the already stored fat within our body, that is utilized by our body. But the same thing is there in this camel also. First, it has padded feet. The feet of the camel, if you have seen, that is such like a soft cotton feet they have, which help them to walk easily in the sand. Number two, long legs keep them away from the heat of the sand. Heat of the sand, they keep them away from the heat of the sand. Number three is, it has hump, which is used to store fat. Now, hump on the body is used to store the fat. Now, what else? That camel drink a large quantity of water. All these adaptation of camel is very important. You can write it down, these for 1, 2, 3, or you can take a screenshot right now here, and then I'm going to erase it, and I'm going to write the few more adaptation of camel. So now 1, 2, 3, very important: padded feet, having hump, and long legs which keep them away from the heat of the sand. Now number four, they can drink water. Camel drink a large quantity of water and store it in all the water cell. So you can write water, it can drink large quantity of water, large quantity of water, which is stored in their body. Water which can be stored. So large quantity water they were drinking, up to 40 liters they can drink, and then they can store that water inside their body. And whenever it is required, if they are not getting water for next 3, 4, 5 days or 1 week, they can utilize that water. Then they have nostrils, have flaps. It has seen that nose of camel, they have flaps, which does not allow those sands to, even the camel can walk in sandstorm also. So that that nostrils having flaps which close the nostril during dust storm. So the nostrils have flaps which are closed during dust storm or sandstorm. Now also it has huge eyelashes also. If you have seen eyes of camel, they have huge eyelashes which does not allow to enter sand in their eyes also. That is why they will be able to walk in that dust storm also. So they have huge eyelashes, help to keep them away from sand. Keep them away from sand. So these are the certain adaptation which is present naturally in camel and which help them a lot when they have to walk on sand, if they have to walk in desert, and how they will be able to survive in desert. Now the last point is also very important, that you can remember only that camel can adjust their body. Like in hot weather is there at a daytime, but cold nights were there at the night. So that camel can adjust their body according to that. That camel can adjust their body temperature according to that. When the daytime they have hot weather, then also they can adjust their body temperature by drinking water and all. And at night when they are cold night, then also their body can be adjusted throughout. So all these things are very important. First, First three which I have told you, first let's revise. First one I have told you that the camels have padded feet which help them to walk in the sand easily. They have long legs which keep them away from the hot hotness of sand. Number three, it has a hump which help them to store food in their body. Number four is it can drink a large quantity of water which can be stored and that can be stored also. Number five, the nostrils have flaps. Flaps means it can be closed. Flaps which are closed during dust storm. Huge eyelashes help to keep them away from sand. Fine. So it will huge eyelashes does not allow sand to enter in their eyes, and they can easily walk in that sandstorm also. Now next, what is important thing is that they can adjust their body temperature. Like when we have hot and humid weather, we use artificial things, like we use cooler, we use fan, we use ACs to get cool our body temperature. But their body is so adjusted, so adapted to the desert that they can adjust with the temperature, what temperature they have in the daytime as well as the night time. Nowadays also, if you went to Rajasthan, you find it out ample of camels, those who were used by the people, those who were living there. Even if I say that camels are the most important part of desert area, then that is not wrong. Actually, desert area is the dry terrestrial habitat in which the animals, those who are living, they cannot survive at the daytime, all the animals. But camel is so adaptive in that desert area that is why camel will become so useful for the people, those who were living there. So very important things were there related to camel, like such of the adaptation. Take a screenshot of all these adaptation in camel. Now adaptation of particular place you are going to do. If you can't do that, then just you go through that adaptation of particular animals. So all these adaptation, all these physical features of a camel you have seen, but you were not knowing it about that, why all these features are helpful. Like in our body, if I talk about our body, that in body fine hairs were there present in nose. What is the advantage of that? What is the advantage of that? Now the advantage of that is, what is the advantage of that? Fine hairs which is present in your nostrils. So advantage of those fine hairs is that they do not allow to enter dust particles inside your body. That dust particle will keep on hanging, or that will be fixed with that your fine hairs only, and then later on you can remove them, or you can clean your nose, you can blow your nose, and they will be removed from your nose. So with this adaptation we have finished. Adaptation is an important part of this chapter 7. So now we are going to start with this checkpoints. One checkpoint and then wrap up. Now we are going to do it. Checkpoint: long winter sleep in polar animals is an adaptation. Is it true or false? Long winter sleep in polar animals is an adaptation. True or false? Yes, it is true. Long sleep during winter, that is known as hibernation. That is mainly done by the polar animals, those who are living on southern pole and northern pole. Actually, what is there, that the animals, those who are living in southern pole and northern pole, these animals have those who are living in southern pole and northern pole, they were having, that is such kind of an adaptation that they can sleep. Since in southern pole and northern pole we have 6 months day and 6 months night, so what they are supposed to do it at night, some of the animals, those who are finding food at night, but most of the animals, they do hibernation. they sleep for the 6 months, and the next 6 months they are going to eat and they are going to find their food. So that adaptation is known as hibernation. Number two, thick layer of fat in polar bear insulates his body. Yes, that thick layer of fat which is present on the body of polar bear, they work like a insulation. What do you mean by insulation? Which does not allow anything to enter inside their body. Heat cannot be removed from their body and cold cannot be entered inside their body. So then that thick skin is working like a insulation. Now the phenomenon of blending with the surrounding is called arboreal. No, that is false. Now this the phenomenon of blending with the surrounding is known as camouflaging. Camouflaging, animals, those who are living in tropical rainforest, animals those who are living in that is other polar region also, all they do camouflage. Camouflaging is done by all. Now camouflaging is what? When they blend their body according to their outer areas. Like if polar bear can merge with that white snow, so we won't be able to find it out that where polar bear is standing. So by which they can kill their prey also, they can get their food also, and also they will be protected from their predator also. So this phenomenon is not known as arboreal. Arboreal habit means when some animal can stick to the trees, they can climb to the trees, they can walk over the trees. That is arboreal. Now hot and humid forests are present around the equator. Yes, hot and humid forests are present around the equator. Yes, that is true. Now movement of animals or birds in group to escape extreme climatic condition is called hibernation. Again false. Movement of animals or birds in groups to escape extreme climatic conditions is called migration. So this is the actual definition of migration only, that movement of animals or birds in group to escape extreme condition. If animals want to escape from the extreme condition, they migrate from one place to another place. How is it so? That like birds, they escape or they move in group, like Arctic tern, Siberian crane. They fly in a group and they come to another part in winters. Since in winters they do not have such kind of a weather where they were living, they can survive over there. So that is not known as hibernation, that is known as migration. Hibernation is the long sleep during winters. That is known as hibernation. So with this we have finished all the adaptation. Adaptation we have done in the animals, those who are living in tropical rainforest. Then separately we have seen that the animals, those who are living in Indian tropical rainforest, like Indian elephants, what kind of adaptation they must be having to survive in that particular environment. So adaptation we have seen. Then we have seen adaptation in polar region also, how polar bear, how penguins were survived in that particular environment. Then what we have next, we have adaptation. What kind of adaptivity they have, adaptation they have. Adaptation in the animals, those who are living in desert areas, that we have done. So I hope a quick revision, a checkpoint which we have done, that will make clear certain points in your mind, like migration, hibernation, and camouflaging. These are the certain points which are very important, and there is a small difference between all these things. So now I am going to go through with the exercise. A quick summary of this whole chapter, we are going to take it tomorrow. After that we will start the exercise part of this. Exercise from NCERT book we are going to do it. After that, same way we are going to opt with the same method. Then we are going to do it with the, yes, with that extra questions also we'll see of this chapter. 7 weather, climate and adaptation. So here I am going to finish the class. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.